Day, and we want to invite you to get involved, support Autism Speaks, and make a difference for families living with autism. Join a walk near you or become a volunteer. Here is the address, www.autismspeaks.org, to learn more. Well, the Fort Wayne Mad Ants turn it over. I see one change in the lineup. Ryan Whitman, probably the hottest shooter in the league right now, is in the lineup. We also see, looks like Wayne Chisholm is in there for the Mad Ants. Here's a three ball from the top of the key. Swish, it's down for Dominique Coleman. And now four of the five Skyforce starters are on the board, and the Mad Ants now find themselves trailing by four. In the forecourt, Kramer on a drive down the lane, puts it up, may have been deflected. Sean Marshall will run it out. Fed ahead on a break, bounce pass, McCray off of the glass and in. 4 points for Chris McCray, and right now, the Sioux Falls Skyforce have it blowing and going. In the forecourt, Kramer, bounce pass, Howard. Pump fake, he's obstructed as he started to drive Dominique Coleman. That is his first, the team's second. That's a common foul. Reset of the shot clock to 14. The ball will be given out of bounds above the foul line extended right. Wayne Chisholm gets the ball. He's playing without his headband tonight. I hardly recognize him without that headband. Gets the ball off the block. Sykes defending over the middle, left hand. Didn't get it. Rebound in traffic. Battle for it. Foul. Let's see. It may have been Lazar. They gave the foul to Darnell Lazar. That is number one on him, and the Mad Ants first. So Fort Wayne has had two substitutes in the game already. No substitutes as of yet for the visiting Skyforce. In the forecourt, Ryan Whitman. And they get it down on the block, Raymond Sykes. They tried to feed it into traffic. The pass was too hot to handle for Agunye. Mad Ants on a run out. Kramer to the basket and scores on a good feed from Ron Howard. 7 first quarter points for Chris Kramer. And that cuts it to a 4-point ball game. McCray up on a long two and he puts it in. McCray can get him in spurts. There's no doubt about that. Smooth score from Maryland. And they had him earlier in the year and then lost him for a while and got him back, but he is a definite asset. There's no question of that. Here is Howard, 3-point range to the right. Chisholm sets a screen. One dribble and a shot. Two balls not off the mark wide left. Sean Marshall has it. Sioux Falls leading by 6. McCray going to make it 9. Missed on a three ball. Agunye with an offensive rebound. Sioux Falls will reload. Lob play for Sykes. He puts it up. And let's see. They gave the foul to Chris Kramer. And on Kramer, that is his first and the team's second, and there will be a timeout coming up at 2:15 remaining first quarter of play. D-League basketball will continue with a score. Skyforce 25, Mad Ants 19. Well, we have 2:15 remaining in the first quarter, and the Skyforce right now have their largest lead of the game at 6, and Sykes, with the ponytail flowing, makes it a 9-point quarter for him and extends the lead to 7. Sykes again, and Raymond is right on the money. Boy, Clemson must have really been something when he was playing there. 8 points the lead at 27-19. Fort Wayne trailing here. Kramer on the baseline. Wayne Chisholm tried to reverse to the left hand, lost the ball out of bounds. Fort Wayne turns it over. Well, I tell you what, the Mad Ants cannot afford any real loose play here because they're still in a playoff race. And right now, it's the Sioux Falls Skyforce that look as if they're playing for a playoff spot. McCray around a brush screen from Agunye to the baseline. Sean Marshall feeds it. Agunye in traffic. His hook shot was blocked against the glass. Out of bounds. Fight for the ball. It will go to Fort Wayne. So it'll be tossed in. We'll get a station break in here pretty quickly. We're under 2 minutes to go, actually approaching 90 minutes. Stop and go move by Howard, drops it off. Chisholm off of the glass and puts it in. Wayne Chisholm on the board. He has his first two. And the Skyforce lead is at 6. Skyforce played Erie really well Thursday night. Jumper on the way for Coleman. No, it's tipped in. They gave it to, or went in. Dominique Coleman gets credit for the basket. He has a total of 5. 1 minute to go in the quarter. Ron Howard around a screen from Lazar. Feeds it back. Lazar is wide open, and he hits the shot. That was what they referred to as a block and fade. In that, rather than rolling, the screen setter actually rolls outward rather than inward toward the basket. Here is a great move by McCray. He faked to pass it off and just anchored everybody in cement, took it right to the basket. Here is Ron Howard on a one-handed scooper. Madheads get it back at the other end, and it is end-to-end right now. 31-25, Skyforce by 6. Difference between the clock, 7 seconds. Sean Marshall, left wing, 3 ball, left it short. Rebound knocked out to Chris Kramer. He'll bring it across. Matt Ants will hold for a shot, trailing by 6. Ron Howard with it, 7 seconds. High screen, Howard, 4 seconds. Fed in the corner. Ryan Whitman, a 3 ball, went deep in the cup. No, tipped out of bounds. And let's see, the horn sounds as the battle was on for the ball, and the first quarter is in the books from Fort Wayne. We'll pause. D-League basketball will continue with a score. Super.